We had seen that an electron moving in its orbit could be considered as a current-carrying coil. Therefore, it would have a magnetic moment. In this case, if we look from the top, then the movement of the electron is in the clockwise direction, which is equivalent to a positive charge moving in the anticlockwise direction. Then, from the right-hand rule, we have the magnetic moment pointing upwards. Whenever we think of a current-carrying coil, it would be equivalent to a magnet with the same magnetic moment. So in this case, the magnetic moment is upwards since the electron rotates clockwise when viewed from the top. So you can think of this electron as a tiny magnet with its north pole upwards and the south pole downwards. Let's take a piece of metal, and for the sake of simplicity, let's say we have just two atoms, each with one electron rotating. This is just a hypothetical example. You can see that they do not rotate in the same plane. The net magnetization of the material depends on the orientation of these two magnetic moments. In this case, since they are not aligned, we can say that the magnetization is partial. Let's look at some other extreme cases. In this case, the magnetic moments of both the electrons are parallel and they point in the same direction, that is, upward. In such a case, the magnetization is maximum. You can think of this model in terms of small magnets where all the individual tiny magnets are aligned. So their magnetic moments are aligned, thereby providing the maximum magnetization. Here, the magnetic moments of both the electrons are anti-parallel. The electrons actually rotate in opposite directions. The magnetic moments point in opposite directions, that is, one downwards and the other upwards. In such a case, the net magnetization is zero. So if you think of this model in terms of small magnets, they are cancelling each other's magnetic moments, thus yielding zero magnetization. Take the case of these two metals. In metal A, the magnetic moments are all aligned, whereas they are not all aligned in metal B. So the net magnetic moment of A is greater than the net magnetic moment of B. A and B have equal volumes. Magnetization is defined as the net magnetic moment divided by the volume. So the magnetization of A is greater than the magnetization of B. For metals with a higher magnetization, the magnetic field is stronger. Since the magnetization of A is greater than the magnetization of B, the magnetic field of A would be greater than the magnetic field of B. So the magnetic field is proportional to the magnetization. The higher the magnetization, the greater the magnetic field. The magnetic field can be expressed as mu zero times the magnetization M.